Looks to me like we're somewhere possibly in Texas, but if we are, it'd probably be in the eastern part of the state. Saw some tractor tires running through there, so there's probably a food plot there somewhere not too far away.
Now, this deer looks pretty young. He's pretty thin yet through there.
You know, I think he is. That, to me, is a real young deer. And I'm a little bit concerned about this deer. If you look at him, his hair coat's pretty rough. He doesn't have a whole lot of flesh on his body, so maybe he's coming, you know, maybe there's been a problem. Maybe he's had some health problems or something down the way.
And that deer's on the move, looking for something to eat. Here he's in a good spot to shoot. He's busy, but man, there, that, everything changed, didn't it?
Immediately. He saw him moving up there in the tree. Now he's totally, not only suspicious, he's suspecting something's gonna happen any moment.
Yeah, I think he's keeping that eye open for danger. Tough shot right there, though, at least from what we're seeing. Oh,
oops.
Man.
And there he spooks. And now you've got your hands full, because this buck has seen movement or heard someone.
But yet, he's coming back for more. That is amazing. That deer's keyed up, but then he's hungry.
Well, he's still pretty well protected, though, when you get right down to
him. Oh, there's...
Right there. Oops, maybe not. Oh, something spooked him again.
God.
Again, he's looking. Finally, there's an open shot. But at this point, I mean, that deer has got him pegged. His ears are forward. His eyes are concentrated. His nose is working. Everything's working against you right now, even though it's just only 17 yards.
This to me is a classic setup for you call the shots, jump the string. That deer knows something's going on. The only saving grace here is that buck has spooked, what, 3 or 4 times now and hasn't left.
No.
If it's me with most of the whitetails I'd hunt, I wouldn't be taking that shot, because I'd be afraid he's too keyed up, and no matter how low I shoot, I'd probably make a bad hit. What do you think?
The only good thing is if you saw it earlier, he was at full draw a little bit earlier.
Yes,
so I believe he is still at full draw. So if he swung from there, you've got a clear shot. If you aim a little bit low at 17 yards, I'm thinking you might be able to still take it, although it is really risky and definitely could still jump the string.
I'm not sure. I'm kind of like Mark. I think if it's particularly this was somewhere in Texas, I think I'd be waiting for a little bit better deer. Not to say that that's not a good deer, because he certainly is, but at the same time, I think I'd hold off on
him. He's high strung. He's not the best buck in the bush, probably. It probably, again, to me, I would probably hold off that shot, at least in most of the areas I hunt.
And he does drop down, but the shot is still good.
And he didn't drop that far either, so. But just like you say, the shot's really good. That deer's not going to go very far.
I'm convinced that that's not a normal deer. Because deer in my country, they don't give me 4 opportunities. They give me 1, and they're gone. So, but he read the deer right. You know, again, he saw that the deer had spooked a few times and hadn't left. He figured he could get the shot off without jumping the string, and that's what you got to do in those cases. You got to go with a gut feeling. His gut feeling worked.
Yes, it did.
North American Hunter is